This video covers exception handling as implemented by C++. Exception handling gives us a way to detect and gracefully recover from errors that are detected in the program during runtime. C++ uses a try, a throw, and a catch to implement exception handling. Any type of code that can fail should be placed in a try block so that you can throw an error and then you can catch that error. A common error that can occur is an attempt to divide by zero. Here is a sample program that is written without exception handling. The program is set up to determine an average score. The inputs are the total score for all the participants and the number of participants. The program then divides the total score by the number of participants to come up with an average score and then displays that average score on the screen. This program works fine as long as there is a number placed into participants that is non-zero. For example, if I have a total score of 105 participants, then the average score is 20. What happens if the total score is 100 and then the number of participants is entered as 0? The program tries to determine the average score by taking 100 and dividing by 0. Well, you can't divide by 0. The program exits abnormally and the program fails. So there could be a whole lot of other stuff after this in the program that needs to be done, but the whole program just dies. Here is a program implemented with exception handling. This time, the divide by zero code is placed inside of a try block. Before we do the division, we're going to test to see if the denominator is a zero. If the denominator would be a zero, we'll throw an error. And we can give an error identification. This time, I just made up a number of zero. Here's what happens when we have good numbers. The total score, again, is 100. The number of participants is 5. The denominator is going to be a 5. We won't throw an error. We'll go ahead and do the divide and then print out the display saying the average score is 20, and we'll skip the catch block because we didn't throw an error. Run the program again. The total score is 100 again. The number of participants at this time is 0. The if statement is going to test the number of participants, find out it's a zero, so we'll throw an error instead of doing the divide. When the error is thrown, we're going to skip the rest of the try block, immediately go to the catch, and see if we can catch the error of zero. We do. We'll display a message saying, error zero. Participants cannot be less than one. Anything else we need to do, we can do in here. Maybe it's something where we have to close files or close a network or whatever we need to do to finish up and tidy things up before the program ends. This is the end of the introduction to exception handling implemented by C++. You should have enough information to use this in your next project.